After cytoskeleton, our next video is on cell junctions. What are cell junctions? They are contact sites between cells and the extracellular matrix.
These are made up of a complex of proteins. Based on where they are located, what is their functions, and what type of proteins are present, there are various type of cell junctions. Functionally, we can actually divide them into three type of cell junction. What are they? The first one is the zonula occludens, which is otherwise called as the tight junctions. The next one is the anchoring junctions, and the third one is the communicating junctions, which is otherwise called as the gap junctions. Now, these anchoring junction is further subdivided into four types. The first one is the zonula adherens. The second one is the macula adherens. The third one is the hemidesmosomes. And the fourth one is the focal adhesions. In this video, we shall see about the tight junction in detail. We can have certain descriptions to describe about the tight junction. First one, it is the intercellular adhesion complex. So what does this mean? The intercellular adhesion complex, it means it is present between two cells. This is one cell, this is the other cell. Then where are they located? They are located in the epithelia and in the endothelia tissues. The next point to describe the tight junction are that they are going to control the paracellular permeability. For that, we need to understand what is paracellular permeability. Let us consider this to be one cell and this is another cell. This is the apical domain and this is the basolateral domain. Cellular transport and paracellular transport. If a substance is going to be transferred across an epithelium by passing through the intercellular space, okay, this is the intercellular space, then it is called as the paracellular transport. Whereas, if a substance is going to pass through an epithelium by passing through the cell itself, in that case, it is called as the transcellular transport. So the tight junctions are the ones which are going to control the paracellular transport. The next point is they are the apical most of all the junctional complexes. And the next point to describe them is we know that it is zonula occludens. So that means they are going to be belt-like. So they are going to encircle the entire cell. We first need to understand two terms, zonula and macula. The term zonula means it is actually belt-like. And the word macula means it is spot or patch-like. So the final point is they encircle the entire circumference of the cell. Moving on to the structure of the tight junction, let us know certain terms. First, we need to understand three important components for the intercellular tight junction. The first component is the transmembrane adhesive protein. The next component is the cytoplasmic attachment protein. And the final component is the cytoskeletal element. Okay. So what are the different types of transmembrane protein present in the tight junction? The first important transmembrane protein family is the claudin family, is the occludin proteins. The next family of protein are the junctional adhesion molecule. We can call them as junctional adhesion molecule. Now, in this diagram, we can consider this to be a claudin, this to be claudin. This is one cell, this is an adjacent cell. And this can be the occludin and this can be the occludin. Then we also have the cytoplasmic plaque proteins. So these three important family of cytoplasmic plaque proteins of the tight junctions that are zonula occludens 1, zonula occludens 2 and zonula occludens 3. So let us consider this to be zonular occludens 1, which in turn will interact with zonular occludens 2 or zonular occludens 3. And in the tight junction, the cytoskeletal element is the actin filaments, F actin filaments here. The cytoskeletal element in the tight junction are the actin filaments. So in this diagram, we can consider this to be the actin filament. The transmembrane proteins are present as strands. So based on the number of strands and based on their degree of integrity, the tight junctions can be either completely impermeable or they can be leaky. Of the secretory cells of the salivary gland, only 2 to 3 strands of the transmembrane proteins are present. So they are relatively leaky. Whereas in case of the, this is the secretory cells of the salivary gland. As in case of the striated duct of the salivary gland, there are 8 to 9 strands. Therefore, they are completely impermeable to water. This is an important VIVA question, or it can also be asked as an MCQ. Now, let us move on to the function of the tight junctions. So, moving on to the functions of the tight junctions, we can see that the first function is that they control the passage of material through the intercellular space. So, they control the passage of the material through intercellular space. They are the ones which are going to maintain the two important domains of the cell, that is the apical domain and the basolateral domain. When we see the clinical manifestations, two diseases we can name that can be caused because of dysfunction of the tight junction or any of the proteins of the tight junction, that is the inflammatory bowel disease and the celiac disease.